Hello everybody, Jason Basin here, and this video is about the vintage 16-step sequencer of Analog Solutions, and I talk also about the ARP X. Okay, let's do it. This is the Analog Solutions 16-step sequencer with Oberkorn sliders. It's vintage. They don't make it anymore. If you find one, it will be on the second-hand market. Here we have the section of the CV with the sliders. And then underneath we have the gate section, gate X and Y. You can set them, we have two rows, let's say, of gate possibilities, rows the gate X and the gate Y. Then we have here the outputs for the CV, this section, and the output gate X and gate Y here underneath. We have put it here, so in CV, and I have already linked it to the ARP-X, to the ARP-X CV in. And this one, gate X, this gate out, I have put it into the gate in of the ARP-X. Then we have here sequence control, the tempo, and then we have here all little things out, and we will see what that gives. I will demonstrate that. We will one time put the CV cable into all the holes, and then afterwards we will put the gate X cable into all these holes, and we will see what happens. We have here a run stop and an internal stop and an external stop, and we have here resets, here also resets, reset to 1, reset to 16, and we have here a step knob. So we're gonna demonstrate that now. All right, we're gonna activate the sequencer. Here on the sequencer, here on the X line, I have there are three positions here on the handle. I put it upwards here on step 1, step 5, step 6, step 7 upwards. And here step 15 upwards, and you hear where we get a melody out of the ARP-X with this. When I to demonstrate, so every time I put here a handle upwards, I become in the gate X sequence, and I can change the melody that we hear. So, a lot of possibilities. Now we're gonna take this CV output and put it into here. That's the external clock. Now the internal clock. Then I have here step one. Then I have here gate A. Then B, port B. As we can hear, we get each time another sort of sequence. Then D. And the last one, reset. So we put it back here in CV. Now we're gonna take the gates X jack, mini jack, and we're gonna put it also in all the possibilities in all these holes. First we start with the clock external port. What do we get? We don't get nothing. Then the eternal clock port. Step one port. Port B. Port C. Port D. We have the reset port. What do we hear? Nothing. We're gonna place it back here on gate. From here did we start? So, as you can hear, there are a lot of possibilities with this sequencer, and this is only, we have only experimented with gate X. You can also experiment with gate Y, you can make all the settings, different settings, a lot of possibilities. The Oberkorn sliders, the 16-step sequencer of analog solutions. Now, as an extra, what are we going to do? I've put an extra cable. We're gonna place it here into gate Y. And we gonna start the sequence. And now We're gonna put this black cable into all the holes. Nothing changes in the clock external. Then the clock internal. And it stops the sequencer. Then step one. Nothing changes. Then here A. B. Then C. Then D. And reset. Another experiment with this sequencer. I've put the sequencer on a hold, so it's not working. And it's very curious. We're gonna see what happens with the cable that was in gate X. We're gonna put it now in all the holes and we see what happens. First, the clock external. Nothing happens. Then the clock internal. Step one port. A, nothing. B, nothing. C, nothing. D, nothing. And reset, nothing. Recently, I saw some videos on YouTube about the theme of Doctor Who, a cult series on in the UK. And the original theme was made with the sequential circuits Prophet 5. Afterwards, other composers, another composer made it with the RRP Odyssey. He used the RRP Odyssey, the ARP Odyssey, to make this well-known theme. So I asked myself the question, can I make such a sound, the Doctor Who sound, with the ARP X? I believed that I could do it, and we will see if it's possible in a few seconds. You must know the ARP Odyssey and the ARP X are derived from the one of the mothers of all synths, the ARP 2600. So the ARP X has a lot of capabilities. It's possible to make any kind of sound nearly with such a synthesizer. So I recommend certainly this ARP X or an ARP Odyssey to everyone who is involved with making music, with who want to search some good sounds, make some good sounds. So we're gonna do the test now. And we will see if it's possible to make such a Doctor Who sound. As you could hear, it's possible to make such a sound. You hear this sound without effect. It's real straight out of the Orb X. Thanks you for watching. Bye bye.